In this video, we'll see the culmination of all of our work and see this thing stand tall for the very first time. Two years. Wow. Okay, what's happened? The first time this project was announced and I heard about it was actually the first time I met James at the GTA Expo in 2016.
We're even planning on doing a power loader from the Aliens movie.
Hey guys, hope you enjoyed the expo. I'm here with one of my fans who's been with the channel since the original Elysium lift. This is Boglin.
Shortly after, I ended up working at Hacksmith Industries. A few years had gone by until I brought the project up to James and asked if the Aliens power loader was still something he'd be interested in making real. He said he was, so we started this project over Christmas break in 2018. By that summer, we had one fully working arm, but I had to put the project on hold to train and compete for Mechatronics World Skills in Kazan, Russia. While I was away, James found this amazing facility and the team had started the tedious process of moving in. After getting settled in, we completed our first large-scale project here, the half-scale Cybertruck. And with this success, we decided to bring back the power loader. But just as we started to ramp things up again, the pandemic hit. No team, no budget, no power loader. Well, we survived the pandemic and decided to continue this project this past fall after James managed to secure a partnership with Caterpillar, the official manufacturer of the power loader in 2100. With the 239D skid steer as the base and power unit for our project, it seemed like we were finally within arm's reach of completing this project. And in this video, we'll see the culmination of all of our work and see this thing stand tall for the very first time. But first, we're going to have to get this thing painted. But wait, wasn't this thing yellow a year ago? It was. And we were so excited that we rushed into painting and did a pretty poor job. We didn't even use a consistent painting method. Some parts were glossy rolled on paint, while other parts were a dull spray paint. It was a mess. This is a big project for our channel, so let's do it right. Caterpillar gave us buckets of the official Caterpillar yellow, so let's head out and get this thing painted at Engineered Lifting Systems.
We're here at Engineered Lifting Systems and they have this giant paint booth and we're gonna paint the power loader. Oh, get a whole bunch of these guys. Now, this company makes all kinds of awesome products, from overhead cranes to material handling conveyor belts and everything in between. In fact, the way we met them is because they're actually fans of the channel and they donated a crane to us called an Easy Arm. You'll see that later in the video. When I came for a tour of this facility, I noticed they had the giant paint booth and I had to ask, can we paint the power loader here? Because we really can't do that at our shop because we don't have a paint booth and it's really big to paint. They said yes, so we're gonna get started.
First coat complete, time for lap two.
All right, guys, the painting is done and it looks phenomenal. Chris, you did an amazing job, really, really nice. Which means this week, it's time to put the entire thing together. Chris and Dave, you guys are with me. We're gonna try to put everything onto the cat and get the whole thing assembled. And Tyler, I'm gonna get you working on the roll cage. Sounds good? All right, let's get to it. First up, we're gonna install the legs. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring the forklift over, get some straps through the holes, gonna lift the legs up and over top the cat. I'm gonna set it down slowly and put some bolts to hold it in place. Sounds good? Dave, you wanna get the forklift? Chris, you wanna get the lifting straps? Keep going. And... okay, we're good. That's in there. So now we've got 16 of these bolts to put in that is gonna secure the legs to the cat. And that should make it really, really rigid and should be able to hold the full weight of the maximum load for the power loader. Get to screwing these in. We had some difficulty getting the legs in the first time because one of the hoses was kind of interfering. So we've readjusted the hydraulic hose and everything fits now. We got all the bolts in. We just have to tighten them and we can move on to the chest.
So I'm gonna be making the roll cage. This is what I'm gonna be using and I'm gonna be cutting, grinding, and welding it all together. Let's get started.
The next piece is gonna be the chest. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to put the bushings into the legs, get them all greased up and ready. Then we're gonna pick this up the exact same way we did with the legs. We'll use the straps, pick it up with a forklift, bring it over, slowly lower it down. And another person is gonna need to take the bushing tube and slide it through all both of the legs and all of the bushings. Hopefully once that's done, the chest will be secured. We can put the bolts in and then the chest will be fully attached. We have the upper body fully mounted now, but as you can tell, it can actually still rock forward and back, which is gonna make it really difficult for us to put the arms on. In order to solve that, what we're gonna do is we're gonna install the rear hydraulics, which will hold the upper body straight while we put on the arms. Let's get to it. Oh, that's nice. Perfect. So now the last step is just make sure it's all the way back. Okay, so the rear hydraulic cylinders are in, which means this thing should no longer move forward and back. That means it's time to start doing the arms. First things first is gonna be the rear back muscles / deltoid plates. Do those first. This power loader is getting so close to completion. It's a ton of work. I need some time to unwind. And what better way than to engage in massive tank battles with a global community? World of Tanks is free to play, and with over 550 tanks and 40 different battle arenas to choose from, the action is different every time. If you're as picky about the details as I am, you're gonna love World of Tanks. It's historically accurate. The tanks are authentic models and feature characteristics that will make you feel like a real general. Take your tank across open fields, climb steep hills, sneak through forests, tear across deserts, and pick your battles in urban industrial zones. If you're a new player and register on the Wargaming portal using my link below, you're gonna get 250,000 credits and 7 days of premium access. Plus, if you sign up using my link below, World of Tanks will get you off on the right foot, or tread, by giving you 3 rental tanks for 10 battles each. I'll see you on the battlefield. These are the next pieces we're putting in, and these are what I call the deltoid plates. These are actually the back muscles that allow the entire arm to lift. And these have to be very strong because they actually have a very large mechanical disadvantage. The cylinder is really close to the arm, so it needs to be able to hold a lot of force. They're made out of air 400 plate steel. Really strong, but really heavy. So hopefully this goes well. We've only done this once before, and this thing was a lot lower to the ground. So, We'll give it a try.
There you go. Oh, it just kind of went. There we go.
Adding this grease makes it way, way easier for us to get the tubes in and to get everything aligned. But also, the grease will actually prevent the steel that isn't painted from rusting. So that's going to make this thing last a lot longer. Okay, so the deltoid plates are all on. We have to basically fit them into the shoulder and then drop in the giant pin. We got that bolted in, so now these things are fully secure and they move really well. which means the next step is the arm. So I think what we're gonna do next is actually hook up the electrical system again, drive it back a few feet. That way, we have the assistance of the crane to move the arms into place. Let's do that now. All right, so next up, we're doing the biceps, and these holes right here are actually gonna go onto the deltoid plates. So we're gonna basically pick these up, they're gonna slide onto those big bushing tubes, and there's an end cap that screws on with one giant bolt to hold the entire arm on. But before we do that, we have to put the linkage plates on first, and that's what's gonna allow the deltoid cylinder to control and lift the entire arm. All good? All right, so there's one over there, there's one over here. If both of us can grab one. This is all ready, we're gonna pick it up with a crane and hopefully be able to slide it onto the shoulder. Okay, we got it. Over this way. Watch the bushing. That's two arms, or two biceps. Okay, so the bicep is all the way on now. As you can see, it can swing freely and it has nowhere else to go. Jeez, we got the pan and the bicep now. Next up, the forearm. The forearm is up next, but before we put that on, in order to make our life simpler, we are actually gonna attach it to the wrist first. So we're gonna put the wrist onto the forearm and then get the forearm up onto the bicep. Got an arm now. We got this entire arm fully assembled now, but we're not gonna start the other one because we're actually waiting for a few more bushings. So while we wait for that, we're gonna put in some of the hydraulics. So because the arm is just swinging around right now as we're trying to put pieces on. So now this part is gonna be locked. So when we do the front or the hand, it won't try to swing back and forth. So we have to do the same with the bicep as well as the deltoid and the shoulder. Oh, yes, we got it. Okay, so next we can install the shoulder hydraulics, which are gonna go inside the body. We gotta pull those pins out, get them nice and aligned, and then hopefully drop the pins through. And that'll hold the shoulder still while we're installing the rest of the arms. This is how you use a hammer, right, Chris? Last cylinder for this side.
Oh my god!
We ended up lifting the arms into place with our forklift and putting the bushings in, getting them screwed in so the arms are fully attached to the upper body now. Then we installed the hydraulics to make sure that nothing moves while we install the arms. So next up is gonna be the hands, and to do that we're gonna install the bearings and then the palms are gonna go onto the bearings. These bearings are actually called cross roller bearings. Hey Google, shut up for like 3 minutes. No, don't get louder! These are called cross roller bearings, and these are used for industrial applications where you need a lot of force and easy mounting while being very low profile. For example, our power loader palm. These can actually hold a lot of weight in every direction and are supposed to be super reliable and super robust. Let's see if they hold up to our application. Fingers crossed. We'll install the hydraulic motor, fixture the entire palm in place, and that'll allow us to put the cylinders and then the fingers in. Hopefully we'll have a fully working hand. Yep, look at that. It fidget spinners.
So all the pieces have been cut and beveled, so let's start welding.
The finger attachment mechanism is actually really complicated, but it works, so we're gonna stick with it. Basically, you have this linkage piece that has to go on the cylinder first, into the hand, and then the finger will slide into the back, just like so. But first, we're gonna do the motor. Grippers are up next, which is actually the harder part. Okay, almost ready for fingies. So we're gonna put the hoses on first, then get it into the gripper, so that when we get around to wiring up all the hydraulics, the hoses are already there, and we don't have to pull the hydraulics back out. That should give you as much room. Go. Dip, I think that's good. That's 2 seconds in. I think it's all good for you. It's all good.
Man, this is awesome. Hey, Bogdan. Are you sure you used the right scale model of me in SOLIDWORKS? The roll cage seems a bit small.
Okay, so getting it upright was actually the easy part, but we might have to make some adjustments to the roll cage. In the next episode of the Aliens Power Loader series, we're gonna dive deep into the control system, which may possibly be the hardest part of the entire build. So it might be a little while before that video comes out. But in it, this sleeping giant will finally come to life.